When you think of Siberia, you probably imagine frozen tundra, gulags, and wastelands. Although some are accurate, Siberia has much more to offer. Siberia accounts for more than 75% of modern Russia. There is simply no way to describe the total landmass of this hostile region. Siberia is larger than Canada, has more natural resources than any other region in the world, spans 9 time zones, and contains the world's largest plain. The Gulag system is one of the best ways to give you an idea of the size of Siberia. When one thinks of a Gulag or prison, images of armed guards, electrified fences, and so on come to mind. The majority of gulags in Siberia lacked fences or any other type of barrier to keep people in. With freezing temperatures in the winter and massive rivers and mud and water in the summer, Siberia served as natural gulag for many of the prisoners. When a prisoner escaped from a gulag, he had nowhere to go. The nearest populated area could be 1,000 miles away. Siberia is derived from the Mongolian word Sibir, which translates as sleeping land. Siberia became an exiled region in the early 18th century, and for much of the 20th century it remained top final stop for criminals and political exiles. Since the fall of communism, Siberia has witnessed a voluntary migration of Russians working on the Trans-Siberian Railway, or in the vast natural resources sectors. Siberia is home to massive oil, gold, wood and diamond resources. With the transition to capitalism, the country is making an effort to capitalize on such resources. This has resulted in an increase in population in places such as Irkutsk, Chita, and Ulan-Ude. Chita is actually known as the city of exiles. Siberia is frequently portrayed as a land of ice and snow. It gets extremely cold in the winter. Temperatures can fall to minus 40 degrees. In the spring and summer, however, temperatures can reach as high as plus 40 degrees. Climate and temperatures vary greatly across such a large area. United States could fit in Siberia, illustrating how temperatures might differ. Lake Baikal is the world's largest freshwater lake. It is fed by over 300 rivers and is effectively an inland sea. There are over 30 islands on the lake. Even if all of the water from the Lake Superior, Erie, Huron, Michigan and Ontario were drained, Lake Baikal would remain unfilled. You can see the other side if you are standing on one side. It's just enormous. Siberia is one of the world's last remaining wild adventure travel destinations. You can fish, walk, camp, hunt, drink vodka, ski, swim, go to spa and pretty much do whatever you want. Siberians can take hell of a story and are generally very nice people. I definitely recommend you visiting Siberia.